You're watching UNICEF television. Perched on a pretty Himalayan hilltop, Shiradi is a village poor, rugged and remote, like many others in the far west of Nepal. No real roads, no electricity, no services and no men. Gone to greener pastures for work in neighbouring India, they leave the women behind to toil alone on tough terrain for most of the year. Their gender, their geography, holds them back, and here too, their caste. South Asia is a region of widening gaps between rich and poor. Unique caste divides cut deep. Only Dalits or low caste live here. They're called untouchables.
Some villagers ask us to stay away from them, while some treat us equally. If we go to their houses to have meals, we have to wash our dishes ourselves, and then they take the utensils only after sprinkling purified water on things that we have touched. Not all treat us as untouchables, but some would not even allow our shadow to fall on them. We need to spread cow dung on the floor where we sit so as to cleanse it.
Time seems to have frozen here. Extreme poverty added to age-old traditions delay development by decades. Like this 14-year-old girl, they marry young and unready for babies. When girls are menstruating, they're sometimes forced to live in an outhouse for fear they'll bring bad luck to family and livestock.
The Chaupadi goat, where the women go and spend 4 days when they have their periods. Many other villages over here, they don't practice that culture. Similarly, this whole custom of the far west where the men go to India to work, and the poverty, the caste system, it's just so hard eking out a living in this area.
There is a community health worker, but no medicines. There is a school, but the poorest drop out early to seek work. They're unreached and unequal. Many villages in Nepal and India are separated by caste. Here, symbolically, up on the hill, are the haves, the upper castes. Below are the lower castes. A new push for progress for the country, for the region, means health services like these reaching out to all children with equity, making sure all are vaccinated, all are treated, and none are left just hanging. With more than 1.5 billion people in South Asia, this is where the bulk of the world's poor live. The region is moving forward with increasing speed, but the cycle of economic growth could mask the true picture if millions of poor are being left behind. Change needs a faster pace here. For now, though, in this far corner of Western Nepal, too many children and women are cut off and carrying too great a burden on their own. This is Sarah Crowe in Shiradi, Nepal. Unite for Children.